Here we go. Go. No. 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 Should be able to do this. Go. Go. Boom. Welcome back, guys, to another Boom Beach video. Today, I am back on my mini account, and I'm going to be using some Hooka today. Now, a couple people wanted me to use Grenadiers on my low-level account. That is coming, but you know what? It's Hooka. It's Hooka. Hooka Mania right now, which means 90% off, which is amazing for a lower level like me, and I can gym them up without costing too much because I don't have endless reserves on this account. I only have endless reserves on my two top accounts. The Rising Rejects are going strong, guys. If you want to join our Task Force family, go down to the description, click our Discord. We can get you into the Task Force, but it's a lot easier to do on Discord than the YouTube comment system. Now, I don't know how I'm going to be using Hooka today. I can either be smoking to the HQ, or I could just be, you know, landing them and just letting them go and trying to clear the base. I think I'll do a little bit of both today. For a base like this, I think it would be better to do something smoky, and I'm going to switch up my combination here because I don't want to fail too badly on camera. So I know I said smoky Hooka, guys, but honestly it's gonna be more like one boat of heavies, the rest boats of zookas, and we're gonna try out a couple things. Now keep in mind, I haven't tried Hooka at a lower smoky AZ or smoky Hooka outside of an operation base on this account before, so this could either be really good or pretty freaking bad. Okay, we're gonna take down those oh, we have Everspark. We do not want Everspark. Everspark is good for tank medic. She's good for other troop combinations, but not for something smoky. For something smoky, you gotta bring Brick and you gotta bring her battle orders, because that's where you're gonna get the firepower. So, we need our heavies to tank up these mines. We're going to use our brick here, but we don't want to kill off all of our heavies because we still need our heavies to tank over here. And I'll kind of show you my strategy. I'm hoping it'll work, but chances are it will not. We're going to land our troops, and we're going to try to get them all grouped up here. And we're going to flare them down here. They're going to go through that crevice, guys, and we're going to drop our smokes. Now I'm hoping we won't hit any mines. Looks like we did hit a few. We're gonna drop a flare up here, and we're gonna do a little reverse smoke. We have 31 gumbo energy, which is good. I'm gonna get grouped up here. We're gonna drop a flare down. Keep in mind, this guy is a couple levels higher than me, but you know what? We got this. That was easy, guys. We haven't even destroyed it yet, but I'm guessing we will. Oh gosh, did I speak too soon is the question. No, we did not. We did it, guys. We did it. That's what I'm talking about. Auxum? AUX? Is it AUX or AUX? It's a debate I don't want to get into. Some people will say, pass me the AUX cord. And some people will say, pass me the AU. Okay, it's definitely AUX. I've heard people call it the AUX cord, but I call it the AUX cord, so. Not an ox cord, an aux cord. Okay, let's gym up our troops here and let's scout out this level 55. Now, keep in mind, I don't have a lot of damage on this account. I do have a bunch of damage statues. I'm trying to have this account. When I finally max it out, which is going to take a long time, when I finally do that, I'm wanting to have more of a 5 damage, 5 gumboat energy statue loadout. And I think that's going to work better than more gumbo energy. So this is going to be the powerhouse. This is going to be the account that can come in and just destroy a base with a bunch of damage, but not something that I need to flare half across the base to defeat. Okay, guys, we're going to be attacking him with DC Yusuf. What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to get my zookas right here in between these sniper towers, and I'll need pretty much one shock on the rocket launchers. And if I have more energy, I'll drop one on the shock blaster, but it's not a big deal if I miss it. I could defeat this base with warriors, but that defeats the purpose. It's Hooka Mania, so we're going to use AZ instead. We don't need to clear mines because we're going to use our hero to clear the mines for us. Will they spread too much? That's the question. They won't. The way I'm going to walk, they're not going to split. Because there's no 4x4 buildings right here in that area. There's a spot if you put a 4x4 building. I'm not going to tell you because it's super annoying with AZ and warrior players, but there's a spot in here where you could drop a 4x4 building that makes your troops split up for the path I'm gonna be taking. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drop our hero, drop our other troops slightly behind. Now our hero does walk faster, that is fine. We need to let our hero walk out a little bit. We're gonna drop our flare down and we might hit that mine. I'm hoping by, we missed it, okay. Perfect. Now we can't let our hero, we might peek there. We're gonna drop a flare back here. Yeah, we lost our hero. It's just too much. We used her to tank mines, but honestly, guys, my smokes need to be upgraded. I think I'll still be able to do it. His rocket launchers aren't that high of a level. I will have enough for a med kit and a shock. Hopefully, my zookas won't be stepping out there. Nope. We're gonna drop our shock down because we already lost the delay. We'll get a med kit down, and we should be fine. And that was a mistake. I think if you're gonna do, if you're gonna try using this path I just took, use your hero. If you need your hero to tank mines and you're as low a level as me, you're gonna lose your hero. So unless you, if I dropped my flare back, I could have made it, but I might have had to use an extra smoke. But we did it. 31 losses, not very clean, but we accomplished our goal. We will use heavies. This is the heavy base you guys want to use heavies for. So we're gonna bring two boats. I'm doing all smoky today, guys. They said it couldn't be done. A guy on my task force said you can't use AZ if you have under 80 gumbo energy to start. And you know what? No, you can use it with a lot less gumbo energy. I could probably do these bases with 50. Some people could do them maybe with 40. Okay, let's do this. So what I'm seeing right off the bat, there's no serious splash damage over here. If I go on this side, we have mortars, but it seems a little more. I'm gonna go on this side because I won't have those machine guns pointing at my zookas. So we're gonna take down a sniper tower here with the mortar. Perfect. And we will use our hero and our heavy boat to tank the mines. We'll drop our AZ right behind. Kind of sloppy on the landing. And I'm going to let them fan out a little bit. So we make sure. Okay, we lost a hero. That's fine. We lost a couple zookas. That's fine. You don't want to waste too much smoke. Just making your hit clean. Like, if it's going to make the difference between you winning and losing, you can spend a little less smoke. And a little, you'll get a couple more losses, but we'll be able to do this. Heavies will tank all the splash damage, but this stupid machine gun, we'll drop a never med kit, That's how much gumbo energy we have, and we were able to take down Manic Saha. I'm sorry, man. The name's Saha, more like Sadha, because I'm laughing at your sadness. Okay, we did it. This would be an awful strategy to clear your map with. I mean, you can take down some pretty high level players, but we're gonna do them later. Okay, you always want to scout out a player because you never know when someone is going, what is this guy doing? You never know when someone is gonna be a noob and put the HQ on the beach trying to drop victory points. But this is even worse than putting your HQ on the beach, dropping green statues, then on top of it boosting those green statues. Now, if I planned this out, I bet I could figure out a way if I was fully boosted to do it. But no, I'm not going to. We're going to try this. This is not going to go well. We're going to try it. There's 0% chance I'm going to be able to. We'll say 1% chance I'll be able to pull it off. And I'm not doing too much planning. I don't want to use AZ. Ooh, two buds of heavies. That should be fine. I don't want to use AZ. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use one shock and my heavies to tank up damage. And I'm hoping and I'm praying that I'll be fine. So I don't need my troops to tank mines. So I'm going to drop my zookas first. Then I'm going to be dropping my hero and my heavies because I can't have my heavies or my hero get out in front of my zookas too much. We'll drop our flare over here so they completely miss those mines. It doesn't matter. Ooh, I do not like that. Oh no, this is not going to be good. My troops are going to have a weird little... Oh, dang it. Oh, this is... Okay, I'm only attempting this once, guys, because I don't want to waste too much diamonds. You're doing something that's just impossible, and Oh, my zookas are gonna wrap around, and they stepped out. Oh, dang it. The mortar's gonna be hitting. Dang it, I should've, maybe we'll try it one more time. That was a lot closer than I thought. And I think if I planned it out right, oh, we're gonna do this. We're gonna beat this base. This is not a very hard base. I thought it would be way harder. I misplaced my shock, and I'm gonna fix that little flare when my troops separated. But my landing was perfect, and my walk up to here was perfect, but everything else was not perfect. So we're gonna drop our flare back here to start, and what that's gonna do is our troops are gonna be forced to take this kind of close to the shoreline, and we didn't even peek there, which is how boss I am. And we don't want to lose the smoke, so we'll drop a flare up here. My troops will spread out a little bit. And two smokes at the end. And my troops will walk out of there one more time. We're going to activate our hero. Our hero doesn't step out. None of my troops step out. Okay, it's the perfect hit so far. My shock was down. Perfect. We'll drop a med kit because that machine gun, and boom, it goes down. So for those people that say it's impossible to defeat people more than 10 levels above you, it's not. And even for a person unboosted, granted, it is Hooka Mania, but that shouldn't matter when you're in battle. You just have to find weaknesses, and that guy had a major base flaw. Those corner bases can't defend against AZ. So now I have confidence built up. We're gonna do one more hit. Now, someone like this, where he's fully focused on defense, not the last guy who was focused on offense, this one might be harder. This is the type of base that you don't want to see, and I don't think even how much I tried, I can defeat this base unboosted. So we're just gonna click find a new opponent. So it's all about finding weaknesses and bases, and like I said before, corner bases and corner bases over here. Are they still called corner bases? I think so. Corner bases are super easy to take out. This guy has nice, not really nice statues. He's going offense, which I like to see, and his defenses are under leveled, which I like to see. His rocket launchers are higher leveled, which I don't like to see when I'm using AZ, but I'm just keeping these rhymes out. That didn't rhyme. Okay, we're gonna get AZ and we're gonna do a corner flare like that first one we did, and I lost who he was. Was it this? Nope. Okay. That guy had the same base as the other guy I just defeated. Who did we just scout? This guy. Here we go. 49. Not that high. 7 more levels than me. We're going to take down these mines because I have no intention to be losing my hero. I'm going to keep... Oh, we dropped our hero. We're going to keep our hero close to our troops because I don't want to lose her. We're going to drop our flare up. And the rocket launcher... fired, but we should be fine. They're gonna be forced to take this little they're gonna be forced against the wall. We're gonna drop a flare down here because I have no intention to lose half my army because my smokes wore out. We'll drop a flare up, drop the last smoke, and we should be fine. We'll get a med kit down. We'll have no, we won't have enough for a shock. Oh, we are dead. That shock launcher is gonna fire. Can we flash kill it? No. I said it was easy to take out, but it's not. Okay, we're gonna be defeating this guy for the first time of the day. And we're gonna group up here. Then we're gonna group up here. I don't want to lose half my troops because my smoke wore out, guys. This is what we're going to do. We got this. And I don't want that rocket launcher to fire. Either. We're gonna flare in between. Our hero is out in head, so she will tank up that mine for me, because Brick does have a lot of HP. We get one more smoke down. We shouldn't gap there because I'll be forced against the wall a little bit. Perfect. We're gonna drop another smoke because they're not all there. We're gonna drop our flare up. Our troops walked out. Oh, that's not good. We're gonna drop one more there. We're gonna drop a flare. We're gonna activate our ability 6. No, we're not gonna activate our ability because that would give us no energy for the shock launcher, which we need the shock. Here we go. Go. No. 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 That was even worse. Okay, what did we do wrong? I look like an idiot now because I said it was easy to take down any corner base. But it's not. There are still corner bases. This is an easy corner base also, so I kind of feel slightly embarrassed because I may have misled some of you guys. So, we're going to drop our troops first like we did in the first attack. We're going to group up. We're going to drop a flare. You know what? A 1x1 landing might be better. Then our smoke isn't gonna be wearing out because my troops will be in a clump. So if we fail one more time, that's what, oh my gosh, you see that smoking? Oh, beautiful, that's what I like to see, guys. And smoke at the end because my troops gonna walk out. We'll drop a flare up, one more smoke. And we'll drop a flare to the core so that they don't spread out too much. We'll activate our ability. None of them peek deck the back. We have enough for a shock and a med kit. And the med kit's going to heal up from the flame. And we should be able to do this. Go. Go. Boom. That's what I like to see, guys. And a little too much energy, maybe. But energy is good because it gets you pumped up. Okay. And that's going to be it for the video. I kind of find it funny that we defeated a level 56. No real problem. We lost once, but then we challenge a level 49 and we lose a couple times. But anyway, guys, that's going to be it for the video. If you liked it, be sure to drop a like. As always, make sure you subscribe for daily Boom Beach content here on Cosmic Duo. I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Bye.